We have a great interview for you. We have a very talented artist with us. His artwork has been displayed at numerous fairs, as well as custom art pieces and galleries. And beyond that, his work has also been featured on HGTV's Flip or Flop and the DIY Network's Restored Show. He's not only a fine artist, but he is also an interior designer and a stager. Please help me welcome David Michael Guerrero.
Thank you. Thank you, Anna, for having me. City of Fontana, Mayor, and everyone involved, thanks for having me out. And I really appreciate the program that you guys have here. It's a great honor. So thank you very much. And thank you to my guests for showing up, coming from dealing with the traffic and all. And thank you for the guests that are here as well.
We're excited to have you here. Your work has gotten a lot of interest, and people especially are interested when they find out about all your pieces are named after Beatles songs. So we're excited to talk to you more about that. Share with us your story on how your artist journey began.
Sure thing. A little bit about the titles. I chose something that was going to be somewhat of a connection to someone not knowing the arts. I wanted something that was familiar to them, so they can kind of already have a sense of the artwork and visual, and kind of put one and one together, having a title like a Beatles title to artwork, and hopefully they could kind of meld together and have an experience all new. So regarding my journey as an artist, it's all kind of been a encompassing journey, and it all started with just drawing and exploring with the pen and pencil, and so it's been developed from just design and doodling and, you know, expressing myself through that. And you know, if I ever, you know, when I talk to kids and the children, they I always encourage them, just keep on drawing, keep on doodling, because, you know, this is something that will end up, you know, later on down the road. So.
Oh, that's really interesting. I know you said you got inspiration from growing up near Elysian Park and Dodger Stadium, and it's really nice to see how it kept evolving and turned into these beautiful art pieces.
Yeah, it's a good point. I growing up just below Dodger Stadium, I'm the last house going into you know, the rest of the city. So, you know, I say I grew up in LA, but it's really the outskirts and right just below Dodger Stadium. And so my surroundings were trees and rocks and all this texture. And so that was my world as, you know, from 5 to 10. And I think my love for texture and all that and nature is one of my big inspirations. And so you'll see trees in the artwork, you'll see waves, and that all derives from that one moment, those moments as a child.
Wow, that's really quite impactful. Now, I know your artwork's captivating, it's beautiful, and you've described your technique as non-traditional. So talk to us a little bit more about your technique, mixing mediums, and how you know when a painting is finished.
Oh, okay. Those are tough questions. but I'll go into the way I feel about a piece is first it begins on the blank canvas, and I feel like the canvas can talk to me and tell me, okay, you know, you should start here and go forth. And you know, I know it sounds silly, but it does. So if it doesn't have enough texture to begin with, then I'll add a layer of texture before I even begin like doing any color or anything like that. So there's a lot of base colors and things like that. But it's, yeah, very non-traditional in the fact that I use mixed media, inks, acrylics, resin, and just anything I have on hand. I'll tend to use graphite, pencil and pen on top of all that. So yeah, there's not just one thing I use. I tend to treat it as an experiment, and if I do it one way the last time I made an art piece, then I'll do something different that next time.
Oh, wow. That's really interesting. That's a bunch of different techniques each time.
Every time it's going to be a different story. Yeah.
Now, what inspires your paintings? Is it landscapes? Is it just feelings?
You know, it depends. So on the commercial side, it's going to be what the client demands. And then on my personal side, it's going to be personal feelings. And again, it's going to be nature, trees and rocks and texture and all that really talk to me. But when it comes to the TV show, you know, they'll give me, you know, we have greens and blues in this house. We'll need, you know, some artwork to go along with that theme. And so that's all I'll get. And then the rest is up to me to kind of convey what they want to see and how dramatic. I don't know if anyone's seen the show, but at Flip or Flop and this time and age right now where we're using whites and grays on the walls, they want a pop of color. And so that's what I bring to the table is the pop of color and you know, TV and the camera, you know, really enjoy that. So I'm glad to lend that to them. And then one more thing, I do have an announcement. I received a phone call today from another staging company working on another show.
Okay.
It's called Flipping 101. And it starts Tarek. And so the phone call went so that they wanted me on the show as well.
Oh, wow.
So I'll add another TV show to my list of ongoing.
That's amazing.
So it's been a great day.
Yeah, that's wonderful news. Yeah. Now, how did these opportunities come about? How did the first one kind of evolve? And what's it like being, you know, part of these shows?
It's always fun. There's a lot of energy being on set and having things filmed and actually, you know, helping in the staging as well. It's really neat to be like behind the scenes. And then once in a while, I'll be on camera placing up an artwork, you know. So there's a lot of perks, but it's just enjoyable. And it's really fun, and everyone I work with is really nice. How I got the gig is just like anything else. It's a friend of a friend, and you know someone, and you know, need some art, Dave. You know, we need some art. Let's go ahead and work something out, and that's just how it happens. But I will say the other two TV shows will be just random. At a show, like you found me at a show, Pasadena,
yep.
I believe. And this other one was Monrovia, where I did the restored, where they found me there. So it's just being out there, doing these shows. You know, it's not about selling at the shows, it's the connections. So that's my main advice is just, you know, try to be out there as much as possible.
And that's really great. And you really worked the connections to start in it, but it must be such a great feeling that people all over the country get to see your artwork.
Yeah, that I don't try not to think about that too much. but it is nice, you know. Like I say, my quote is, you know, these artworks, they're famous, but I'm not, because I rarely get to be on you know, behind the camera, or in front of the camera, I should say. But you know, for instance, this one in particular has been in probably like 3 episodes of Flip or Flop of either season 7, and season 8.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And if they, this one and this one, they're more on the newer side, or the colors didn't go with the decor. So
they didn't get featured.
Yeah. They didn't get featured.
But. Now, who's really influenced you? What artists have influenced you, and how do you incorporate that into your artwork?
That's a good question. I don't think there is one in particular. I will say that I do enjoy like Picasso for his color. But I would say my first art teacher, I have to go back to Bob Ross, and you know, everyone understands Bob Ross and has seen him. He really embodied in the enjoyment of the art. And so I tried to, convey that and enjoy it and be a part of the art, for every single one that I do. So, I love artists and I go to museums as much as possible. But when it comes to my art, it's just so spontaneous, except for, commercial side, that, I don't lend towards them, but they just become. So, yeah, hopefully that answered that.
So they inspire you, but you don't necessarily incorporate it into
Yeah, I don't draw into yeah, the painting. Into that, yeah.
So in order to reserve your space or find out about any of our upcoming cultural arts events, please visit our website at arts.fontana.org or call the Art Depot Gallery at 909-349-6975. Thank you very much.